A recent survey on counterfeit phones and electronics indicated that out of 1.3 billion phones manufactured globally every year, 180 million are fake. The counterfeit and substandard phones find ready market in Africa. A genuine phone can turn into a fake phone once its IME code is tampered with, as lawyer Fred Muema explains.
And according to the regulations, the SIA, what I'll call the SIA, a stolen phone, though it is originally genuine and original, it becomes fake. It becomes counterfeit. If you go back to the definition of counterfeit communication apparatus that I showed you, you'll see that in the definition, if the IMEI is cloned or stolen, then that becomes a fake. The question again might be, but if my phone had an original IMEI number and you steal it, does the IMEI number become fake or cloned? If you ask me, I'll tell you it becomes fake, because an IMEI number, when you go to register or to buy your phone, is given to you as Fred, specific to you.
As part of the anti-counterfeit crusade, a League of the Genuine campaign was formed. Muema says the offense of counterfeit needs everyone to be able to fight.
International mobile equipment identity, same as ESN, as you can see, and the MAID, these are identifiers. Any campaign to fight counterfeits, substandard, fake, must be built on the identifiers. So can we drum these identifiers in the minds of the public the same way we all know 999?
You talked about Kashita. Yes, because we are soon going to the market to see how we can get out fake devices. But we shall obviously collaborate with you, because it is a very, very difficult exercise. But as much as possible, we now want to strengthen our entry points so that these fake and counterfeit products shouldn't enter.
On behalf of the Uganda Communications Commission, Joseph Chizito disclosed some of the measures the communications regulatory body has undertaken to curb counterfeit communication gadgets on the Ugandan markets.
So it's important that you have a genuine phone. It's important that if your phone is stolen, it's rendered useless. That even if the phone is stolen, your money is safe, your data is safe, your details, your pictures, your messages are all safe. So the mechanism to get in there is to make sure we have authentic phones, genuine phones that we can track and say this phone was manufactured by manufacturer X, it belongs to gentleman or lady Y and Z. So what we're doing right now is to consult, engage, so to get to understand, educate the masses when the time comes. And also, purposely mainly today, we're engaging the importers, the traders, the private sector players. So if you go out there to import phones, please understand that you get phones that will work in Uganda. Don't bring a consignment here. After you paid all the taxes, you've injected your capital, the phones get here and they can't operate.
For more than 10 years now, Uganda has failed to enforce the anti-counterfeiting law. There have been several attempts to have the laws enacted, but each time the bill has been shelved, with the most recent one being in 2018.